know. I don't know if I have the camera on or not, but I know I do now. Welcome to the channel. My name's Tim, fishing with House. Come down here bass fishing today and ended up catching some catfish, panfish. I want to call them green sunfish or warmouth or something like that, and some bass. I lost count. I don't know. There was quite a few. Nothing real big except for the catfish was pretty good size. So stick around and watch the video and enjoy. Thank you. Have a great day. Be safe. Well, I just got down here to my one of my favorite spots. Looks like Mama Goose has left from down here and probably got her babies hid somewhere. Her nest was right here. I would speak to her every time that I came down and give her some space. So now it looks like the fishing is pretty much open. I'm starting out with the H2O lipless from Academy that has done so good for me here and down at the other pond that I fish at where I caught the trout. This one was the one that caught the 4-pound 15-ounce trout, rainbow trout, while I was fishing for bass. I was down there yesterday in a video that I posted last night. You see Adam caught a 4-pound 12-ounce bass down there, and I just wanted to come here today because there's nobody here that comes to fish here. Very few people anyway have permission to fish here, and I just wanted to have some time by myself. I didn't invite anybody to go with me. I just needed the time alone. My brother passed away on the 14th of this month. He lived in Atlanta, and my daughter and I drove down there on the 20th, a down and back trip. 10 hours down, 3 hours, I guess, maybe 4 hours for the funeral and the visitation, and then back on our way back up here to Illinois. So we spent 24 hours just between traveling and the funeral. And my brother was a veteran, and this town of Springfield is his roots, and his wishes, final wishes, were to be buried up here at Camp Butler National Cemetery, where my mom and stepdad are buried, and Tom's mother-in-law and father-in-law are buried. My brother, his mother-in-law and father-in-law are buried there. So this past Tuesday, we laid Tom to rest at Camp Butler National Cemetery. So I just needed some time for me today. I'm not really concerned about whether I catch anything or not. I'm just out fishing and probably going to spend a little time with God while I'm out here. Just coming out of the southeast, so I probably really need to be standing in the northwest corner, but I just figured I'd give it a few throws and see what happens. Y'all wonder what I'm using here. I'm using the Lou's Mock Crush second generation edition. It's a 7 foot medium heavy IM8 rod. The reel is the Lou's super low profile. I got my first fish right there. Not a big one. Not worried about size today. Anyway, it's a super, he's kind of feisty, these little guys are, I tell you. You gotta be careful with these little ones. Sometimes they can be more feisty than the bigger ones, especially when that hook goes all the way through them. Dang boy, you have bettered that. Oop. Sorry buddy, no, that didn't feel good either. Always do this right-handed, I guess, since I'm right-handed. Right. And away he went. Gotta figure out how I done that one now. I just don't know how I did that. Anyway, it's a 10 bearing reel. Reel has 10 bearings in it. It's got the dual braking system on it, which means that not only does it have the brakes, magnetic brakes on the outside, it has a centrifugal braking system on the inside. And it looks like, yeah, there's a little knot there. Not really a knot, it's just like a loop. And I'm not going to be able to give a review on this because I've got to deal with this. This hook, I'll be able to fish again. My treble hook decided it wanted to grab a hold of my line, and that's the result. Alright, there. Wow. Okay. Now we still got the knot up here we have to deal with. You don't want to have any knots in your fishing line. Forget about the Mock Crush review. It is a beautiful piece of equipment though. For $225 right now, or $219, somewhere around in there. It's not a bad combo to have in your arsenal.
another one right there.
Not a big one, but okay, so there's number two. A little bit bigger than the other one, but still nothing to say, woohoo, look what I caught. Yeah, buddy. See what I can find here. Sorry for any wind noise that you guys might be hearing today. Not a real big one, but it is a fish. This is number three. Little micro bass. He's cute. Four. They're all small, but they're biting. Go back over there and get my other pole. I'll still take this one with me, but I want to fish with my weightless fluke over here, maybe. Caught 4 fish so far. I'm gonna try right down here for a minute. Felt one hitting on it. Not big. Yeah, buddy. Thank you.
great fishing. I think maybe I will walk down to the other end there, pack up and go. It's not that far of a walk. Maybe just to see what happens, I might just kind of throw it out here. Get the wind coming out of the southeast. So you gotta kind of try to make sure you have your settings right, so if you throw into the wind, you can get the distance that you need without backlashing. So I got pretty good distance out of that. Dinkerdoo. Alright. Let's get out of these small fish and get up there where the bigger ones might be hid. I did want to try, I didn't try yet, so I'm gonna step over there and try it with this. That's where I was fishing earlier with the lipless, and I caught a few. Yeah. Those geese are over there having a ball. Yeah, that's messing up. That's messing up the fishing over there. Maybe, maybe not. No, always find something when I come here. All right, that'll work. kind of chilly out today. It's just barely 50 degrees, I think. Like maybe 48 when I left the house. Illinois got weird weather this year. One day it'll be close to 70, and another day like today it'll be down in the 40s. And man, I just don't know. Oh, he was a little bit bigger too, by golly. Happens when you fish around trees. No matter how big they are, you always got to get hooked up in them one way or the other. It's just law of nature. Get out of there. There we are. I'll move over here a little bit where it's less weeds to stand in anyway. This might be a little bit better over here. That wasn't a giant or anything like that, but it was a little bit bigger. Poison oak right there. I don't want to get down on that, that's for sure. is a 7.5 to 1, and I'm used to a 6.4 to 1 through here. Bluegills want to follow it. Side hooked him or something the way he's twirling now. He just got a mouthful of it. A little bitty shit. Look at you. Big, but he came up and popped it. I can't tell if that's a snake or if that's a turtle right there. Yeah, it is a little bit better one. Not a monster by any means, just a little bit better. Let me help you out there, fella. Not a monster by any means, but a little bit better. Here you go. Service, gentlemen and ladies. Down a few more feet. I really have never fished right here, straight out. Forty foot is the depth of this pond. That's what the owner is telling me. Backlash the heck out of that. No bird's nest, but just backlash, overrun, whatever you want to call it. Wasn't all that serious, I guess. So I either got a hit by head of fish and didn't know it. Must have hit it on the fall. Not a big one. Kind of side hook. Yeah, he must have hit. Ooh, no, maybe I hit him when I was pulling him back. Maybe he was trying to get away from me. Maybe that was it. Dr. Ditch Pickle, you see that micro bass on this big broomstick? I'm going to film this. Maybe if I used my thumb, it wouldn't do that, but I needed to throw that out. There we go. Now I think I got it down enough to take care of it. I'm getting some good airplane footage today. Oh, there we are. That's a good hit. What do we got here? We got a good one here, I think. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. My first big fish of the year on camera, I think. Come on, baby. Come on. Here's a good one. Here's a good one. The catfish. Oh, my goodness. A channel cat. All right. Channel cat. That's pretty good size. Yeah. All right. I wasn't expecting that, but yeah, you know, channel cat bite bass lures. I'm catching everything but bass this year of any size. Picture him so I can send it to George, the owner of the place. Because I didn't bring my other phone with me. Come on, stay still. Been down here. Fish. Now to get him off of there, get him on a scale. Where's my pliers? There they are. Ow! They can bite pretty good, I tell you. Hey, you little shit. Damn. Bit me enough to draw blood. bad thing about catfish. Here's a nice one too. It's gonna weigh about 5 pounds, I bet. Got it. Ow! Shit! Ow! 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 Good. All right. Set him down for a second. I hate to, but it's the only way I'm gonna get a weight on him. I had him out of the water longer than I wanted to. Got the shit stuck out of me. The treble hooks. So let's see. Made a mess of his mouth trying to get the hook out. Poor fella. Alright, see where he's at. Two pounds, 15 ounces. All right. Thank you for biting, buddy. Sorry to put you through all that. Let me get you back in the water here. He's gone. Well, I wasn't expecting that. Maybe it's a good thing I had that heavier line on there. 2 pounds, 15 ounces. Catfish. Hell yeah, I'll take it. Ooh, buddy. One thing, it's time for a line retie. After that, I was thinking about changing baits, but I don't really see a need for that either. So I'm gonna go. All right, bear with me here, guys. I'll turn the camera off for a second. You don't need to go through.